on America's Test Kitchen. Joe makes Julia grind your own sirloin burgers. Jack shares his favorite burger condiments. And Becky makes the ultimate veggie burgers. It's all coming up right here on America's Test Kitchen. America's Test Kitchen is brought to you by the following.
Plucra European-style butter was created for all chefs, cooks, and bakers. Slow-churned with 82% butterfat for a smooth texture and more pliability for flaky crusts. Plucra, from professional kitchens to your home.
On an American Cruise Line's journey along the legendary Mississippi River, travelers explore Civil War battlefields and historic riverside towns. Aboard our fleet of American riverboats, you can experience local culture and cuisine and discover the music and history of the mighty Mississippi. American Cruise Lines, proud sponsor of America's Test Kitchen.
Sur La Table, where you can discover an assortment of provisions for your next meal or gathering. From cookware and tools from a wide variety of kitchen brands to hands-on cooking classes. Visit us at surlatable.com.
For an everyday burger, buying ground meat at the supermarket is just fine. But for a magnificent burger, you have to grind your own. And today, Joe's going to show us how it's done.
That's right. The main reason is taste, and we are choosing a tasty cut. We've got 2 pounds of flat meat.
Right.
So you can ask the butcher or check in the chitter cabinet at your supermarket.
Right, and it's from the lower part of the sirloin.
That's right, exactly. Yeah. So the first thing you want to do is trim the meat, because we don't want any of the excess gristle or fat that sometimes these cuts have on them. Mm-hmm. So you just want to just pick it up and just use the
There's
knife.
There's just not a lot on that, is there?
Yeah, exactly. You want to check on both sides. So that looks pretty good on that side.
Nicely marbled, I might
say. Lift it over. Yeah, this is actually a pretty good one.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to pick it up there and slice it off. You really want to take off too much of the meat, because that's the good stuff. So now we're going to cut this into half-inch pieces.
Mm-hmm.
Slice this down the middle. There we go. And we can just cut that down there.
My mouth is salivating. Just looking at the marbling on that beef.
And now we can just slice them across into these little half-inch cubes. That's our first pound already cubed, and I did the second pound earlier.
Okay, so 2 pounds total.
This is going to be for 4 burgers, 4 pretty hefty burgers.
Yeah,
though.
Nice.
I'm going to transfer all of the meat on a rim baking sheet. When you grind meat, you really don't want it to be too warm, otherwise it can turn to a paste.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to freeze this, and we want to freeze these until they're pretty firm but not fully frozen. I'm going to wash my hands and put them in the freezer. It's been about 40 minutes, and the meat is pretty firm, firm around the edges, but still pliable. We're going to use not a meat grinder to grind our meat, but a food processor.
Love it.
And to be successful, you need to do it in batches. This way, the meat doesn't overprocess and turn to a paste. I'm going to add 1/4 of the meat. We'll have to pulse it maybe 20 times.
Oh, you can see it's just starting to come together at the end. That is the clue.
Yeah, exactly. The more you process it, the more the sticky protein myosin is formed. And that will help the burgers stick together, but we don't want too much, because otherwise they'll turn it into more like a sausage meat.
Mm-hmm.
Which is great for sausages, but not good for a meaty, tender burger.
Yeah, a little too rubbery.
Exactly. And we'll continue to do this until all the batches are done. That's the 4th batch done. Tip it out there. Now we'll spread it out. And any little bits of gristle or large pockets of fat that we don't want in our burgers, we can take out now. When we developed this recipe, we just wanted to choose a single cut. And sirloin steak tips was a great choice here for their amazing beefy flavor.
Mm-hmm.
The problem is they're a little lean, only have a fat content of about 5 to 10%. And for a juicy burger, you really want it 15 to 20%.
Mm.
So we'll make up that difference using melted butter. I'm going to just sprinkle these 4 tablespoons of butter on top. And it congeals pretty much the moment it hits the cold meat. The meat's still pretty cold from the freezer. And now we can just use a fork to toss it together so that it becomes evenly coated.
Very clever. It forms little tiny butter pockets.
Exactly. And those pockets of fat, they're going to render out and just keep the meat juicy.
Mm.
Almost like you're basting it with butter as you're cooking it. Okay. That looks pretty well coated now.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to make 4 burgers, 4 beefy burgers.
Yeah.
We're going to separate it into quarters. So I'm just going to gently pack it into a lightly formed ball so we don't form too much of that myosin. And we're going to gently pat it down into a 3/4-inch thick patty.
That's a thick burger.
Yeah, well, we are going to make sure this meat really counts because we put a lot of care into the preparation of it, and we're going to put a lot of care into how we cook it too. I'm just going to finish this off with a divot. So you just want maybe a 1/2-inch indent. And this is because when you cook the burgers, the sides and the bottom of the meat will contract against the hot pan. And this will cause the top to bulge. This way, they'll still bulge, but they'll bulge to flat instead of domed. We'll finish these burgers off and we can get cooking. I love a good crust on a burger. And how you prep the pan really affects that. So I'm going to heat a teaspoon of vegetable oil in this pan over high heat until it's just smoking.
All right.
We want a hot pan, screaming hot. Now, these burgers hold really well. I don't know about you, but I don't think I can manage more than one of these.
Same.
So we're going to cook two now, and the other two we can refrigerate for up to a day, or you can freeze them for up to 2 weeks. If you want to freeze them, just pop them in a Ziploc bag and separate them with parchment paper so they don't stick together.
Makes sense.
We always like to season our meat just before cooking. If you add salt to a burger, it will draw out some of its moisture, and that can make the burger a little bit tough, and that's not what we want here. It's always a good idea to season from up high. That way you'll get an even distribution of salt and pepper. And make sure you get them on both sides. The pan is just starting to smoke, so we know it's really nice and hot. Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
We are cooking now. We want to cook these until they're well browned on that first side. We want a nice, even browning. It's been about 3 minutes, and the burgers are ready to flip. And you can see they've even started bulging up at the divots.
Yeah.
When I've got something big and awkward to flip, I like to use 2 spatulas. You get much more control that way, and you minimize chance of grease splatters. We want these browned on the second side as much as they were on the first side. This will take another 2 to 4 minutes.
All right.
It's been another 3 minutes, and the burgers are ready. I'm going to transfer these to a rimmed baking sheet so they don't continue cooking. These burgers look fully cooked, but they're still raw on the inside. This is the time to add the cheese. So I've got 2 slices of deli cheese we'll just put on top, and that will melt as the burger cooks through in the oven. To finish them off, we're going to cook them in a 300-degree oven on the middle rack. It'll take about 3 to 5 minutes to get them to medium rare. Okay, these burgers look ready. Let's verify that.
Oh.
Nice and juicy.
They look beautiful.
Let's see what they're at.
For medium rare, you're looking for
120 to 125. And where are we at? We are 124. Perfect.
Nice.
Okay. We'll transfer these to a platter. Pretty much all meat benefits from a rest. That way it'll better hold onto its juices. We're looking for about a 5-minute rest.
Okay.
Once that happens, we've got these beautiful burgers. Let's make a beautiful sauce.
Mm.
I love a good burger sauce. You call this chef sauce, secret sauce, chef secret special sauce. Doesn't really matter. The one thing you do need to remember is the golden ratio of burger sauces.
Okay, what is it?
It's 2 to 1.
Okay.
2 parts mayo to 1 part ketchup.
That's it.
That's it. I've got 2 tablespoons of mayo here.
Mm-hmm.
I've got 1 tablespoon of ketchup.
Mm-hmm.
And to that, we're going to add 1/2 teaspoon of sweet pickle relish. We're going to add more sweet in the form of 1/2 teaspoon of sugar and more sour in the form of 1/2 teaspoon of distilled white vinegar.
Oh, I'm glad you added the vinegar.
I like a little bit sweet, but that tang will take the edge off.
Yeah.
And to finish off, 1/4 teaspoon of black pepper. I'm just going to mix it up. That should turn into a beautiful Thousand Island-esque orangey greeny color. Now we can start building our burgers.
All right.
So I've got some toasted brioche buns.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like a burger of this caliber really wants a bun of similar quality.
I agree.
I like to start with the lettuce, protective layer from those extra juices. Transfer our burgers over. Top with, I think, just 1 tomato slice.
Okay.
Right to me, red onion. Just give it a little bit of that extra allium bite. And of course, a good burger needs a good pickle. Frankly, I like to just eat them on the side.
All right, Joe. Let's see how this is. Oh, it's juicy.
It's juicy.
Which I like.
Juicy, meaty, nice crust on top, nice crust on bottom.
You can't get flavor like this from store-bought ground meat. I mean, it actually tastes like steak.
That's right.
I love that charred exterior, the flavor of it, but the inside is good and juicy and tender. This burger is magnificent, Joe. Thank you.
Yeah, it's worthy of a special occasion.
It is. So if you want to give this special occasion burger a try, grind sirloin flat meat in the food processor. Then drizzle with melted butter and brown the burgers in a skillet before finishing them in the oven. From America's Test Kitchen, a spectacular grind-your-own sirloin burger. This is definitely party-worthy.
Well, we've got two more in the fridge.
Yes.
Should we do it again tomorrow?
Yes, please. Same time?
Sounds good.
Is there anything sadder than a burger on a plain bun? I don't think so. And I have news for you. Lettuce and tomato, they're not going to make things better. They're just going to slide off. What you want is a punchy condiment, something with acidity to cut through all the fat and the meat, and something with a lot of umami to make the meat even meatier. So let me take you through my favorite choices and the Test Kitchen's top-rated brands. Now, where are we going to start? You guessed it, ketchup. Heinz Organic was actually the Test Kitchen's number one choice. Regular Heinz came in number two. This one has a little bit more salt than regular Heinz, which is why we think it did well. It's sweet, it's acidic, it's got all of the umami from those tomatoes. Next up, an unexpected choice, and actually one I prefer to ketchup, which is coarse ground mustard. Now, a lot of coarse ground mustard is really coarse, and what I love about the Grey Poupon, which is Test Kitchen winner, is it has those little pops of those mustard seeds, but it's bound in a creamy sauce. And so it will stick to the patty. Mayonnaise, you want a special sauce like you get in a fast food restaurant. It's ketchup, relish, and mayonnaise, and Blue Plate, available in the South, is our number one choice. Hellman's is number two. My favorite special sauce starts with mayonnaise, but then adds sriracha. I love the Kinkoman, the Test Kitchen winner. It's got garlic, a little bit of sweetness, and it's nice and thick, unlike a lot of other hot sauces. So it's going to make a very thick special sauce for your favorite burger. You want something smoky? You want to bring out the grill notes, let's say, or maybe you're indoors and you can't grill? Barbecue sauce. It's like ketchup, but it's got that smoke element and a little bit of heat. The Bullseye is our number one choice. Finally, I'm going to end with two unexpected choices. Chili Crisp. And you can make this yourself or you can buy this. What I love about Chili Crisp is it's got so much complexity. There's so much going on. There's shallots, garlic, chili powder, Szechuan peppercorns, peanuts. It is amazing on top of a burger. Lastly, compound butter. Now, I always have compound butter in the freezer, and I especially love this one with anchovies, remember umami, lemon zest, remember acidity, parsley, and garlic. And a burger, more butter is going to make it better, right? The fat, put this on not only the patty, but on the bun, and you've got an amazing burger made even more delicious with my favorite condiment. There you have it, condiments, so there are no sad burgers in your future.
The first commercial veggie burger was developed by an Englishman named Gregory Sams, and it debuted back in 1982. Now, fast forward to today, and you'll find vegetable-based burgers everywhere, from your local supermarket to a fast food chain. And they vary dramatically in terms of taste and texture, don't they, Becky?
They really do. But today, we're going to make the ultimate veggie burger, so get ready.
What does that mean?
It means this is going to be the best one you ever tasted, I promise.
Okay, and I see some lentils in front of you.
Yeah, it's based on some nice, complex, savory flavors that has a really satisfying texture. Mm. Lentils, they have a nice earthy taste, mm-hmm. and bulgur that's a little bit nutty. And you can make them in advance and freeze them, so then you have a quick weeknight dinner whenever you want. Let's get going. We'll cook the lentils first. So I have 3/4 cup of brown lentils, and I picked through them already and made sure there were no little stones in
here.
Have
you ever found a stone?
Oh, yeah.
You have?
Oh, definitely.
Maybe I'm not looking hard enough.
Have you started skipping that step?
I have, actually. I've never found a stone, so okay, I'll start.
Oh, definitely. Yeah, you put them on a white plate or a baking sheet, pick through them very carefully, and you'll start finding stuff.
You're putting away family. I've been eating all these years. Okay.
That's 3/4 cup of brown lentils, nice and clean and picked over, and a teaspoon of salt. And I'll turn that on high heat. All right, and we'll bring that up to a boil. And then I'm going to turn that down to medium low and let that simmer until the lentils are tender. That'll take about 25 minutes. So now I have 3/4 cup of bulgur, mm-hmm. and this is going to form the other part of our burger base.
All right.
So I'm adding the bulgur to 2 cups of boiling water with 1/2 teaspoon of salt, and then I'm going to kill the heat. This just needs to absorb that water. It's going to absorb most of it, not all of it. So I'm going to cover that and let that sit for 15 to 20 minutes, and it will have absorbed most of the water by then. Okay, it's been 20 minutes, and our bulgur has absorbed almost all that water.
Yeah, really fluffed up.
Yeah, it looks great. So I'm going to take it over here and just drain off any extra water that might be in there. Just want to press on it a little bit, because we don't want soggy veggie burgers.
No.
These are the ultimate. They can't be soggy. Okay, so that's good. We drained out all the water, and I'm just going to put this into a bowl. I want this to cool down to room temperature. Now I'm going to grab our lentils. Let's drain those as well. These cooked for 25 minutes. Mm-hmm. So I'll just give those a little shake, get rid of any extra water. Now I'll put these guys on a baking sheet with a paper towel to get them nice and dry. I'm just going to spread them out. And these will take about 20 minutes to cool down. All right, so while those cool, let's prep some savory veggies to give these burgers a lot of nice flavor.
Okay.
So we're going to start with a leek. This is one small leek. I just want to use the white and pale green parts. Mm-hmm. I'm just going to trim off the base as well because we don't need that. And then I'm going to cut this in half. So I'm just going to cut this into strips like this. And then I'll turn them like this. And this will create a nice fine chop there. All right. Now these leeks weren't too dirty. They can be super dirty, but of course we want to clean them because we don't want any dirt in our burgers. So I'm just going to put them into a little water bath here.
Yeah, most leeks are grown in really sandy soil, and that soil can work its way up into the layers, and you can't get rid of it until after you chop it.
Okay, like I said, those weren't too dirty, but that'll be good. I'm just going to let them drain there for a second. All right, let's saute these vegetables. I have 1 tablespoon of vegetable oil. I'm just going to heat that to medium high. Let's put in 1 celery stalk that's been minced up. I have 2 onions.
That's a lot of onion.
Yeah. 2 cloves of garlic minced up. And then here's that leek that I chopped up and cleaned. All right, so I'm going to cook this over medium-high heat. I want the veggies to soften and just start to get a little brown around the edges. That's going to take about 10 minutes. So I have 1 pound of cremini mushrooms. You could also use white mushrooms. And I just want to slice them up. I'm going to do the last couple here. I'm just slicing these 1/4 inch thick. If they had some really tough stems on the bottom, I would trim those away as well, but these seem fine. All right, Julia, it's been 10 minutes, and you can see we're getting some nice browning.
Yeah, they've really cooked down.
Yeah, they have. They're nice and soft and a little bit brown, and they smell amazing. So let's just put these on a tray to cool. Remember, we have to shape these into burgers, so we can't have this stuff piping hot. We have to let it cool down to room temperature.
Oh, that makes sense.
Yeah, spread that out a little bit. Now I have 1 tablespoon of vegetable oil, still over medium-high heat, and we'll cook our mushrooms that we sliced. We're gonna cook these for about 12 minutes until they get nice and brown, and these are gonna shrink down quite a bit as well. All right, look at these beauties. It's been 12 minutes.
Those are gorgeous.
They are, nice and brown. They shrank quite a bit.
Mm-hmm.
Those look really good. All right, turn off the heat, and I'm gonna put these to cool as well. It's gonna take about 20 minutes for those mushrooms to come down to room temperature. All right, our veggies are all cooled down to room temperature. It's been about 20 minutes, the lentils, the bulgur. We got everything ready to go.
All right.
So I'm going to just add 1 more element, raw cashews. And they have that nice sort of texture. It's hard to describe. Yes, that's it. A cup of those into the food processor, and I'm going to pulse that 15 times. All right, 15 times. And you see how they're mostly broken up, but not completely?
Mm-hmm.
That's exactly what we want, just to give a little bit of texture. And I have that bulgur that we cooked earlier. I put it into a nice big bowl so we can add all of our ingredients. So let's put the cashews in. And I also have 1/3 cup of mayonnaise. And that's going to give some nice fat to the veggie burgers. It's going to help bind everything together. All right, so I'm just going to give that a stir. That is nicely mixed up. Now let's add our mushrooms and our leeks, onions, and garlic. Yum. All those in. All right, here come the mushrooms.
Oh, those mushrooms are beautiful.
Yeah. So there's a lot here. We're going to make 12. All right. So here's those lentils.
Mm-hmm.
Nice and dry. They're not sticking to each other. Mm-hmm. And that way they won't add any extra moisture. So I'm giving this a pretty good mix.
Those are some pretty big pieces of vegetables still in those burgers.
Well, don't worry. I'm about to put this back in the food processor.
Ah, it'll give it a nice cohesive texture.
Yeah. We want to chop this up. These mushrooms are way too big to use as is. Let's do this half and half. All right, that looks about right. And now I'm going to pulse this 15 times.
Okay, so there's still distinct pieces of mushroom and you can make out the leeks.
Yep.
But it is much more cohesive and sticky.
Yes. All right, in goes the second half. All right, you can see how sticky it is, but mm-hmm. we have 2 cups of panko, which seems like a lot, but that's going to soak up all the moisture.
Okay.
And you're not going to be able to identify the panko in the finished burger. And then a teaspoon of salt. I'm just mixing it in so that that panko can absorb any moisture. Okay, I think we're ready to start making some burgers. Want to help me do this?
Sure.
Okay. We're going to use some half cup measuring cups to make mm-hmm. life simple. This is going to make 12. Just scoop right in there.
Okay.
And then we want to make these 4 inches wide and half an inch thick.
Okay.
Those can be our prototypes.
I see you have a ruler.
I'm going to be checking.
Are you? Let's see how I did.
Oh, nailed it.
On the money.
You could bake burgers with me any day.
All right. 4 down, 8 to go.
Okay. So you ready for some veggie burgers?
I am.
All right. We're going to cook these up. I have 2 tablespoons of vegetable oil heating in a nonstick skillet here over medium-high heat.
Mm-hmm.
Let's get these guys in the pan. So we're gonna cook them 4 minutes. We'll flip them over and cook them 4 minutes on the other side.
All right.
Okay, it's been 4 minutes. Let's take a look here.
I can see them getting golden right around the edges.
I know, you can see those edges peeking out. I'm gonna use 2 spatulas. It's gonna help me give these—
Catch and release.
Yeah, just so they don't break.
Ooh. Oh.
I like how that looks.
I just made my mouth start to water.
Ooh.
Those look beautiful.
Yeah, that looks great, doesn't it? Let's give these another 4 minutes so they get nice and crusty on the other side. And remember, everything is already cooked inside the burgers, so we just want to get that nice crust and they'll be good to go.
Okay.
Then another 4 minutes and they're nice and brown on the other side. Mm-hmm. All right, let's get these on the buns. We have some nice toasted buns here. I don't know about you, I love mayonnaise on every burger.
Piece of lettuce.
Yeah.
2 pieces of lettuce. This lettuce is gorgeous. Nice thick slice of tomato. And then pickled onions. Mm.
Buckle up.
All right.
Okay, here we go.
Becky, that's delicious.
Mm-hmm.
It has such a hearty, meaty flavor. You can't taste the lentils or the bulgur individually.
Yeah.
Altogether, it just tastes hearty, mm-hmm. but also it tastes healthy.
Yeah, but in a good way.
It's yeah.
It's got like some nuttiness in there. It's so savory from all those mm-hmm. vegetables that we sauteed.
Becky, this is indeed the ultimate. Thank you.
My pleasure.
If you want to make a killer veggie burger, start by cooking the bulgur, lentils, and mushrooms separately. Chop the ingredients together in a food processor and add panko just before shaping the patties. From America's Test Kitchen, the ultimate veggie burger. You can find this recipe and all the recipes from this season, along with our product reviews and select episodes at our website, americastestkitchen.com. Yeah.
Let us help you with dinner tonight. Visit our website anytime for the newest season's fail-proof recipes, full episodes, ingredient advice, and equipment reviews at americastestkitchen.com/TV.
The complete America's Test Kitchen TV show cookbook includes every recipe, taste test, and equipment review from all 24 years. It's our most comprehensive cookbook. The cost is $29.99. That's 40% less than the cover price of $50. To order, scan the QR code on your screen or order online at americastestkitchen.com/complete. America's Test Kitchen is brought to you by the following.
Plugra European-style butter was created for all chefs, cooks, and bakers. Slow-churned with 82% butterfat for a smooth texture and more pliability for flaky crusts. Plugra, from professional kitchens to your home.
On an American Cruise Lines journey along the legendary Mississippi River, travelers explore Civil War battlefields and historic riverside towns. Aboard our fleet of American riverboats, you can experience local culture and cuisine and discover the music and history of the mighty Mississippi. American Cruise Lines, proud sponsor of America's Test Kitchen.
Sur La Top, where you can discover an assortment of provisions for your next meal or gathering. From cookware and tools from a wide variety of kitchen brands to hands-on cooking classes. Visit us at surlatop.com.